Welcome everybody to the NHRA Nitro Time Machine. I'm Brian Lohnes. The emergence of Pat Austin as an electrifying young top fuel driver at the 1991 U.S. Nationals brought the drag racing world to its feet. The young man that won the alcohol funny car category and then lost in the final round of top fuel had the world's attention. It didn't take long for Pat Austin to try to achieve the goal that he had set out to achieve at Indy. The vaunted double up, something no one else in NHRA drag racing had ever accomplished, winning both alcohol funny car and top fuel at the same race. The worlds came together in Topeka, Kansas at the Heartland Nationals in 1991, and Pat Austin handled his business in electrifying fashion.
As Pat Austin comes to the starting line, and much to everybody's relief, successfully completes his burnout. Earlier in the finals of top alcohol funny car, Pat Austin provided himself with the opportunity to become the first ever to win two national event titles as Chuck Cheeseman had difficulties and Austin ran a 5.98 low ET of eliminations in alcohol funny car at over 232 miles an hour. That gave him 43 national event victories, second only to Bob Glidden's total of 80. Pat Austin reminds everyone that war, as in Walt Austin Racing, that's him, his dad, has been declared in Top Fuel Eliminator. And nobody knows it better than Joe Amato. The driver of the team Valvoline entry in the far lane's got a lot going for him here in the final round. He has got lane choice with a great 4.97 in the final four. And should he be able to prevail over the 26-year-old Austin, he's gained another 200 points on Kenny Bernstein in the Winston points chase at his quest for his fourth Winston title. Both cars set. And Austin is out in front. Look at the right-hand side of your screen. Pat Austin has won it. He has established himself as a true contender in Top Fuel Racing. A near-perfect reaction time as Walt Austin and Lee Beard congratulate one another.
Pat Austin trying to get composed because he knows he just made drag racing history. No one has ever done what you've just accomplished.
What can you say?
Well, I'll give you more good news. Your first four-second run as well.
I told you it was going to come at the right time.
Yes, you did.
You got to set him up, and we set him up and did just what we wanted to do.
And you drove the wheels off this race car today.
Hey, I got big shoes to fill, and I'm trying to do a good job.
Absolutely. Gary would be proud. The transition from the funny car to the dragster, it's not easy.
I think I rang her out a little high, or a little long and low gear in this thing.
There's only one gear in. Oh, you backdoored it.
Yeah, I did. I mean, I took time hitting the chute. I was making sure he wasn't coming by me. I was going to beat him to the last turnoff, and I think we did that, too. I just got to say that my dad is he's an outstanding individual. He's a great... I just love him to death. He's my dad, my brother, Lee Beard, the crew, Dickie, Dana, Brian, my mom, my fiancée, Keela, and everybody at home. The Tacoma boys hit the big time. We're going in style.
26 years of age, he may be the greatest driver this sport has ever seen.
How incredible for Pat Austin to win in that final round with a 4.07 reaction time, the equivalent to a 007 light today, and to make his first four-second run in the process. The emotions overcoming him at the top end during his interview with Steve Evans, everybody in the world of NHRA drag racing knew at that point a true legend had been born. We'll be back with more NHRA history on the NHRA Nitro Time Machine next time.